An intercept is a place where a graph will cross over either the x-axis or the y-axis. And these graphs can either be of linear equations like this, or really of any curve. But in this video, we're primarily going to stick to graphs that are straight lines. So, like in this example here, I've got a green line here, and there's two places in particular that jump out to me. Right here is a place that crosses the x-axis, and right here is a place where the graph crosses the y-axis. And we have specific names for each of these places. Right here, where the graph crosses the x-axis, we're going to call this an x-intercept. And again, an x-intercept is any place where the graph crosses over the x-axis. And likewise, this place right here will be called a y-intercept. So we're often asked to find the x and y-intercepts for an equation. And what they're wanting is to find where it crosses over the x or the y-axis. Now, that brings up a good question, though. If you're not provided with the graph of the equation, how do you find the x and y intercepts? So let's talk about that for a minute. How do we find x and y intercepts? To explain this, let's actually look at a few pictures and we're going to notice something here. We're going to observe something that's really going to help us. So here's our first graph, and what I want you to keep your eye on is where the y-intercept is going to be. So for this graph, the y-intercept is here. But it could also be here or here or here. So I see a number of different y-intercepts for these four different linear graphs. And I don't know exactly where these y values are, but I mean we can make up some values. Let's say for this one, maybe it's 0 comma 2. And maybe the next one's at 0 comma 3. And maybe the next one's at 0 comma 5. And I don't know, maybe the last one's at 0 comma 8 or something like that. And again, it doesn't really matter where they are. I'm just making up some values here. But what I want to point out is look for something consistent for all of the y-intercepts. Regardless of which y-intercept we're looking at, do you see something consistent? What you should notice is that the x's are always 0 for a y-intercept, 0, 8, 0, 5, 0, 3, and 0, 2, because on the x-axis, the x would be 0 for all of these places here. Well, we're going to use that fact to our advantage. If you're trying to find a y-intercept, what you do is you set the x equal to 0, and then you find what y value that corresponds to. And whatever y value that corresponds to will be where your intercept is. And likewise, I'm not going to draw a picture for this situation, but you can imagine it in your mind. The opposite is also true. If you want to find the x-intercept, you can set the y equal to 0 and find the x's that correspond to y being 0. And you can just think about it. No matter where it crosses on the x-axis, it'll be something comma 0 for all those places. So, anyways, this is how we find x and y-intercepts. So let's close out this video with an example. Let's see if we can find the x and the y-intercepts for this linear equation that we're not provided the graph for. So we'll do the y-intercept first, since that's the one we talked about first on the previous page. So for the y-intercept, remember we're going to let the x-coordinate be 0. So we'll have 2 times 0 minus 3 times y equals 10. And we're going to find the y that makes this equation be true. So 2 times 0 is 0. 0 minus 3y is negative 3y equals 10. We'll solve for y by dividing both sides by negative 3, and we'll get y equals negative 10 thirds. Now, just to be clear, the actual y-intercept is actually a point. So we actually have an x and a y coordinate for the y-intercept. The x, you'll remember, was 0, and the y was equal to negative 10 thirds. So this is actually the y-intercept right here. It's actually labeled as a point. Now, the x-intercept, let's do that one next. Okay, for the x-intercept, we will set the y coordinate equal to 0. So we'll have 2x minus 3 times 0 equals 10. And then we'll solve for x. So we'll have 2x equals 10, because 3 times 0 is 0. Divide both sides by 2, and we'll get x equals 5. So knowing that x is 5 when the y value is 0 should show us where our x-intercept is. It'll be at 5, comma, 0 this time, and let's make sure we get the order of the numbers right. For the x-intercept, the y was 0 and the x was 5. So you'll hear people say informally that the y-intercept is negative 10/3 or the x-intercept's at 5, but if we're being technically correct about it, if we're doing this on a homework or a test, we really need to label the y-intercept as a point. But informally, it's okay to say that the y-intercept's at negative 10/3 because it's understood that the x would be 0 for a y-intercept, and an x-intercept would be at 5 because it's understood that the y-value would be 0 for an x-intercept. So the last thing I want to show you in this video is I actually went ahead and graphed this linear equation here just to point out or confirm the fact that we did get this correct. So here's the x and y axes. Look at where the graph crosses the x-axis right here. It crosses at 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 5, comma, 0 really was the x-intercept. And the y-intercept is somewhere between negative 3 and negative 4. So right here, that'll be at negative 10/3. Labeled as a point, it would be 0, comma, negative 10/3. So you have your y-intercept and your x-intercept. Negative 10/3 is a fraction, is like negative 3 1/3. So that's why it's just a little beyond negative 3. So anyways, hopefully this convinced you that we did get the correct answer. And again, just to recap, if you're trying to find an intercept, you let the other variable equal 0 and then solve for your variable, either x or y.